Let's discuss about degrees of freedom and equipartition of energy. When we talk about degrees of freedom are defined as ways to utilize mechanical energy by a gas molecule these are termed as degrees of freedom. Let's understand it with an illustration, like if there is a gas molecule moving translationally, say with a speed v, which is generally taken as RMS speed whenever we need to calculate pressure or energy. Now, in three-dimensional coordinate system, we can resolve the speed into three components. One is say Vx, other is Vy, and the third one is Vz, such that V is equals to, in magnitude, it is square root of Vx square plus Vy square plus Vz square. Now, in this situation, we can see the kinetic energy of this gas molecule is distributed in three mutually perpendicular directions. And the total translational kinetic energy, when we talk, this can be written as half m dash v rms square, where m dash is the mass of one molecule and v rms is the speed, which is resolved in three directions. So here kinetic energy in translatory motion, it can be written as half m dash vx square plus vy square plus v z square. So this can be written as half mvx square is the kinetic energy of molecule with which it is moving along x direction. Half m dash vy square is the kinetic energy with which it is moving in y direction. And half m dash vz square is the kinetic energy with which it will move in z direction. So here you can see there are three ways in which the gas molecule can utilize its total translational energy. So we can say all gas molecules has three translational degrees of freedom. All gas molecules have three translational degrees of freedom with which these molecules utilize their energy in translatory motion. In sequence, let's discuss law of equipartition of energy. As we have just now discussed that degrees of freedom are the ways in which a gas molecule utilizes its total energy. Now, if we talk about this law, first we write down its statement. This law states that total energy of a gas molecule is equally distributed among all of its degrees of freedom, and the energy associated with each degree of freedom for the gas molecule is equal to half kT, where K is the Boltzmann's constant and T is the absolute temperature. So based on this law, we can state if a gas molecule has F degrees of freedom, then its total energy can be given as total energy of the gas molecule. Mainly we talk about kinetic energy only. This will be written as F multiplied by half kT. If we talk about translational energy, we have just now seen that a particle can move in a three-dimensional space in such a way that its velocity can be resolved into three perpendicular components along x, y and z directions. So, translational degrees of freedom for a gas molecule are only 3. So, the total translational energy of a gas molecule is always 3/2 kT, which we already studied. So, here if we account for other degrees of freedom like rotational motion and vibrational motion of a particle, its total energy can be written as F/2 kT. This is obtained from the law of equipartition of energy. This is quite a useful relation for total energy of a gas molecule. For any type of gas, this expression is applicable. Let's discuss few more advancement and extension of this. Now, for n moles of gas also you can calculate. For n moles of a gas having F degrees of freedom, total energy of gas can be given as, total energy of gas can be written as F/2 kT multiplied by the number of molecules. So, for n moles, number of molecules are n into Avogadro number. The expression will be, here the product of Boltzmann constant and Avogadro number is R, the gas constant. It can be given as F/2 nRT, and this is denoted by the letter U. And this F/2 nRT is specifically termed as total internal energy of a gas, or more precisely n moles of a gas at temperature T. So, we can state the total internal energy of a gas is sum of all the kinetic energy of gas molecules, which is written as F/2 nRT. And we know for translational motion, F is equal to 3, that is 3 translational degrees of freedom. We can see the energy for translational motion will be 3/2 nRT, which we already studied in previous article. We already discussed about it. And this nRT can also be replaced by PV. By gas law, it can be written as F/2 PV also. For some numerical application, this is also being used.